troubling new study to share with you today about colon and rectal cancer, colorectal cancer. It says the risk for millennials and Gen Xers is going up, even though the overall number of cases is going down. So what gives? Joining me now is Dr. Johanna Bendell. She hopefully can shed some light on this for us. She's the director of GI research at the Sarah Cannon Cancer Institute there in Nashville. First of all, you're okay where you are because no severe weather is going through the area.
Yeah, we had tornadoes touch down this morning, but I think everything is calming down a little bit.
Okay, now we'll move on to the medical stuff. Thank you so much, Dr. Bendell. It is concerning when we hear about this overall trend in colorectal cancer going down, but millennials seem to be the group that it is on a vast increase. What do you think is behind it? Is this dietary? Is it environmental? What's going on?
Well, it's really interesting. So for patients under and people under 50 years old in the United States, we see this alarming and significant increase in the rate of incidence of colon and rectal cancers. We're not exactly sure why this is happening, but we think there might be multiple factors involved, including diet. So we need to get more fruits and vegetables into our diets. We also know that obesity is related to incidence of colon cancer. And very interestingly, there's been a lot more research being done on the bacteria in our bowel, and that the bacteria in our bowel might be related to incidence or development of cancers. And with all the antibiotics that we might be taking nowadays, is that shifting the bacteria in our bowel to potentially make us more prone to developing colon cancers?
Here's the question. When you see a trend like this, and especially in this group, is it a trend that can be reversed?
That's what we're hoping. So there's some discussion going on as to whether or not we should start screening patients at an earlier age for colon cancer, to start screening at 45 years old rather than 50 years old. And in addition, for patients who are younger, who are having bowel symptoms, diarrhea or blood in the stools or cramping or unexplained weight loss, should that make people who are younger get to their doctors faster to be able to get an evaluation and possibly a colonoscopy?
Yeah, you know, that's the thing. I have colon cancer in my family history, and so I'm one of those people that they want to watch. But the fact is, the current recommendation is 50, and that doesn't feel sufficient to so many of us. I wonder if they'll readdress that. Dr. Johanna Bendell, in an area that's being threatened by tornadoes, you still made it to our studio to talk about this really important study. Thank you so much for doing that.
Thank you so much.
All right, stay well.